What are you doing with your savings? Did you know that your savings goals could be completely pointless if you're just throwing all of your money into the same single savings account? Mass financial destruction. Mass financial destruction could happen if you are not keeping your savings organized. Don't let that be you, Pearl. There's a simple solution to help you start reaching your savings goals. That all starts with creating multiple savings accounts. What should those savings accounts be for? That's what we're gonna talk about today. Welcome back, Pearls. I'm Brittany, and this is Pennies into Pearls if you're new around here. This is where you are gonna learn how to live your pearl life. Pennies into Pearls is where I want you to be able to come to learn how to do small little changes in your everyday life, help you start achieving these amazing goals that you might not even think are possible right now. But they are totally within your reach, and I wanna show you how to do that. That's all part of living the pearl life. So hit that subscribe button if you wanna start living your pearl life. All right, we're gonna start saving with purpose here, people. Okay, but before we even start talking about our savings accounts, there's a couple different things that you need to get under control before we even start talking about savings. Number one, you and your spouse need to be on the same page with your finances. Any financial conversation is going to be pointless if you know that you're both gonna end up getting frustrated. If you guys haven't talked about your common goals, how do you know what you wanna do with your money? How do you know where you need to save it? So that's important, and I've created the free financial planner kit for couples. Within it, you are gonna find the steps you and your spouse need to start working towards creating a solid financial action plan that is going to help you create a goal-based budget. The goal-based budget is gonna do is gonna help keep you both insanely motivated and excited about what you're doing with your money. Once you have all that set, then is when you're gonna be able to start saving with a purpose. The link for the free financial planner workbook for couples is down in the description box. All right, so where should you keep your savings? Should we keep it under your bed? Maybe down in the basement, perhaps? We don't have basements in California, but you get the idea, right? So of course, you need a bank. We used to be with Wells Fargo. It was just not a user-friendly system at all. Recently, we switched over to Capital One 360. I'm loving it. There's still a couple things that aren't my favorite. Because they don't have very many physical banks, it makes it a little bit more difficult to manage a cash envelope system where we're pulling out cash all the time. What I love about it, though, is it is a completely fee-free savings and checking account. It's easy to open multiple savings accounts, and then with on their website, it's really easy to manage everything in one spot, and I love the way they have things laid out. It's easy to look at and walk through and coordinate with our family's budget. I have my affiliate link for that down in the description box if you're interested in checking them out. Oh, and I especially love how easy it is to move money around between the different accounts, whether it's our savings to savings or savings to checking, checking to savings, all those different things. It's super easy. So why do you need more than one savings account? Why can't we just throw it all into one savings account and call it good? Not only is it going to keep your finances organized so you know exactly how much money is going towards which goal, we like to give each of our savings accounts a really fun name, really specific name, like Couples Thailand Trip 2020. We have that as an actual name for one of our savings accounts. So that way, as we see money go into the savings and that number grow closer and closer to the goal, it keeps us excited and motivated to keep putting more money towards those savings goals. So everyone has different savings goals, right? But there's seven different savings accounts that I think every family needs in order to keep your finances organized. Number one, your top priority, whether you have debt or you're debt-free or whatever your situation is I always recommend having a $1,000 emergency savings fund. You guys know we're big fans of Dave Ramsey, and he's the one that got us on this idea. This just needs to be your top priority. Before you even start paying off any debt, I always say have that $1,000 emergency fund. It's amazing the stress relief that comes when you have that emergency fund set aside and you don't touch it unless it's an emergency. So the second savings account I want you to have is to have 1 month ahead ahead in either your mortgage or for your rent. Having this cash ahead of time for your mortgage or for your rent is gonna make sure that you're never late on a payment again. Step number three goes along the same lines of getting ahead of your bills. So this is separate from your mortgage. Figure out your total expenses per month and then put that money into savings so you are always 1 month ahead of your bills. I've done a video and a blog post on how to get ahead of your bills before. I need to do an updated one, but anyways, I'll leave a link for that down in the description box if you want more information on how to actually get that cash to be able to fund that third savings account for your 1 month ahead savings. Number four, it's gonna be about Christmas. So we've all been there. Christmas time, it's time to buy presents, there's parties, there's all sorts of expenses that come along with Christmas, right? Depending on what we wanna do. But having that money set aside ahead of time for Christmas is life-changing. We put money aside every single paycheck for Christmas. So start saving now for Christmas and have a separate savings account where you can put that money aside and then use it all year long and then put those gifts aside ready for Christmas when it comes up. Your fifth savings account I want you to set aside is for medical and dental expenses. So all of these numbers on how much you should be putting into these depends on your family's personal customized family budget. If you haven't already sat down and decided how much money you could put aside for each of these categories, I highly recommend you check out my video on how to start a budget for beginners. It walks you step by step and how to customize a budget specific to your family circumstances, how you get paid, where you live, all of those different things are all calculated in there so you don't keep failing on your budget. Putting away even just $40 a month into that medical dental savings account is going to be awesome when you have any unexpected events come up. And just as sure as unexpected health expenses are gonna come up, car expenses are gonna come up too. Now you can get really detailed on this and do separate savings accounts, one for a replacement car, one for car repairs, one for car maintenance, things like that. Unless we're saving for a purchase of a car, we have one car expenses savings account, and that's where you put the money away. So when your car breaks down or you need an oil change or anything like that, you already have the cash set aside to get that done. And then just as important as any of these other savings accounts, I always am a huge believer in budgeting in the fun. Now, when we were in our depths of paying off our $20,000 in debt, our fun budget was a lot smaller. Like, we're talking like 10 bucks a month. Hubby and I would have one out of the home date night a month, and maybe we would go and like get ice cream and eat it at the park or the beach or wherever was close enough that we didn't have to spend too much money on gas. It's just gonna be different depending on what season of life you're in. But also having fun savings accounts to celebrate those milestones. Yes, we paid off that credit card. Let's do a staycation. Maybe there's a close by campground that only costs like 20 bucks a night that you could go camping. Budget in the fun stuff. There is something fun that you can do no matter what your budget looks like. But have a savings account set aside so you can have that money ready to go so you can always use cash when it comes time to use it. So there they are. Those are the seven savings accounts I want you guys to start working on. Now, truth be told, we're not perfect on all of them. I would love to be able to start putting more money towards a car maintenance fund and probably start creating a car savings plan to replace our minivan in a few years when it's probably gonna start breaking down. I can't convey in words how much relief having these savings accounts ahead of time. So you have the cash ready to go, how much stress that relieves when all of these situations come up. So do you guys have multiple savings accounts? What do you use different savings accounts for? Have I convinced you that you need a few different ones? Let's chat about all of that down in the comments below. Thanks you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you're new to this channel. If you enjoyed the video, if you found value in it and you're gonna apply something to your family's life, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends. I'll talk to you guys very soon. Bye.